What's going on, YouTube? This is Adam here from LabWorks Auto Detail. Today we're going to be working on my G35. It's a 05 model coupe, and I'm excited to get to do a bunch of work to this thing. It's one of my sought after cars. It's one of my favorite cars, and so she needs a little work. She's a little rough, and I'm trying to not work on the paint as much as possible because we are about to work on the paint. Like, actually, it's about to get a full paint job. So I don't want to put anything on the car to try to make it look better or make it look good. The clear coat is flaking down that side on the fender and on the back quarter panel and everything else. So I'm trying to refrain from doing any kind of wet sanding and trying to get anything pulled out and getting some coatings on the cars. So as of right now, I can work on the headlights, the trim, and everything else. So, and in my professional detail business, I had recently just did a really nice 4Runner. I'll put some, draw some pictures in here. And I had come across this stuff called Cerakote. Now, what I had done to the 4Runner is I basically just did a paint decontamination and a one-step polish, and then did this sealant to it. And guys, it blew my freaking mind. It is so good. I'm sold on this stuff. It is awesome. I used to do, basically just a sealer wax or something like that for somebody who's just getting a standard detail with a wax. I'm using this now for sure. I don't know how long it'll last. I'm not real sure on how long it will last. But man, your finished product, when you're done with this, it's phenomenal. So it was so good, I went out and bought their trim coating, their trim coat. Then I went and got the glass coat. And then I also went and got the headlight. And that's what we're going to be using today. And we're going to be using it in my headlights right now. And I'll just roll some B footage in right now and show you guys the headlights. And as you can see, these things are coated up. They've got a lot of contamination and all that stuff. So I want to see if this will get it out. I've heard great things about their headlight restoration. All right, so now I'm just going to show you exactly what you're going to need for this job. Now, this is what I'm going to use just because, you know, I love doing a lot of prep work. So I just feel like you get the most out of your product when you do a lot of prep. So I'm going to start with just use anything, your favorite APC. And that's mine. I just use that LA Super Clean, or LA's Totally Awesome, sorry. LA's Totally Awesome. I like it. It works good. It doesn't seem to be super, super harsh. So you're going to need some microfibers. You're going to need plenty of water, IPA, and of course you're going to need some gloves. So the IPA will be used on the very last thing before I put on the actual last stage, because this is a three-stage kit. So anyway, so basically what I'm going to do is, well, let's jump into it. Okay, guys, so now what we're going to do is we're going to start out with our favorite APC. I got a little detail brush here. Now, this is just a, I'm just going to throw this out there. If you got some paint, or I'm sorry, if you got some tape, I would tape all this off through here, all the way around the light. Now, you guys can see, my clear coat is flaky, so I'm not too worried about it. But I definitely would recommend on taping all the way around the light and having a good amount of, you know, space. If you've got a nice finish that you want to take care of, I would definitely do that in this part, because their headlight kit definitely have some sanding involved. So so let's get going here. I've got a detail brush and I have a bug pad. I love this thing for glass and things like that. You know, I don't really use it much on paint, but I will if I have to, if it's hard to get off and just lightly rub. Don't really put a lot of stuff in there. So I'm going to give a quick little spray with my APC, which means all-purpose cleaner, guys. And I'm just going to really get everything foamed up good. I just want this thing as detailed as possible, as clean as I could possibly get it, and get that contamination, that yellowness out of there. Because again, you know, that kit is, what, $17 from Walmart? It's super reasonably priced. That's another reason why I really love this stuff. It's extremely reasonably priced. And so I'm kind of anxious to see how this turns out. Now I can see some dirt in this thing, and it's coming out pretty good, or not coming out, but you know, looking pretty good. Get a clean microfiber, wipe your brush out. Look at there. Got some dirt in there. Because I clean my detail brushes out really good. So now I'm just going to come in and really kind of come back and give a quick little scrub to the headlight. But again, you know, this kit is, you know, all of $17. These lights are $400 to $500. So if that's what it looks like when I'm done, I'm going to be super happy. So it should look better in theory, because all that haziness is still back there. So we're going to get this cleaned off real good. Get everything out really good. And we'll let it dry. And then we'll come back and we'll use stage one. Alright guys, it is dry. And so now it's ready for stage one. So let's go ahead and open the box up. Now I've done had it open. I mean, it's kind of hard to go buy something. But this is how it comes out. Okay. It's got stage three, or step three. Oop, put that up there. Now we need the step one. Now, there's a bunch of step ones. Nice. Okay, so anyways, so now my lights aren't super yellow haze. Again, my APC took a lot of that out, so this won't have to work as hard. So let's, that's why I just kind of would rather use also some of my stuff in conjunction with the stuff that's provided. So, all right, so we're going to open this bad boy up. There we go. And it is it's pretty much like a wet nap. So we're going to come in and give her a good clean all the way around the edge. I always go around my edges first to make sure it's extremely clean. And we've gotten every little piece of the light. Now, again, so we're going to have to be very, very diligent about how we do our prep, because this kit is coming basically with a clear coat. Look at that. Wow. So that just shows you, even though you think you may be cleaning your lights well, you're not cleaning it that well. So, but I can tell you now, guys, you're definitely going to want to clean or tape your edges up for sure. Because I've gotten a little bit on the car surface anyways. But see, when I go to get this thing, when I get it painted, this thing is going to be, the headlights are coming out. And, boy, it stinks. It's some stinky stuff. I know that. Look at that. It's pretty insane. Pretty insane. But we're going to go over it one more time. I want to make sure this thing is as clean as I can get it. Now, see, the thing about it is, if you've had lights that are, because sometimes I'll have to do headlight restorations or whatever on some stuff that has been clear coated. So, like, what happens is a lot of these car lots will get these cars in, and they'll have a guy come out, and, you know, which is not a bad thing to do, but the clear coat turns yellow as well. So, you know, it's not really that great. So, we'll get all this stuff off. It already looks a lot better. Like, you could probably come back and hit this with, like, a ceramic coat, and it would probably look much better. But just, wow. Well, that was probably a gunshot. But, yeah, it came out. It looks a lot better. So, I mean, you guys can see it's pretty dry. It could be drier, but it already looks a lot better. Crazy. On to the next step. Okay, guys, now it's on to the next step, and they've got it labeled step two on there. And like I said, this is where it's going to involve some sanding. Now, they provided these, like, I don't know, these sandwich making gloves. I'll wear my own gloves, but, you know, they're in there. If you, you know, are just doing, if you're just on a consumer base and you have no gloves, definitely in there. So I'm under the impression that there is a 2000 and a 3000 grit in here. Yep, there, the gray is your 3000 and the red is your 2, and we already have some on there. Now that's a pretty hard surface, but hey, let's get it going. Now, when I wet sand, guys, I want to get my wet sand, my paper nice and wet, and then we'll get my area nice and wet that I want to work. So when I wet sand stuff, I always work my edges first. I'm going to make sure I stay off the paint. You still want to, you know, even though I don't really care if I get on my paint because my car needs to be painted, I still want to practice that safe practice of you know, not scratching the paint. So keep your sandpaper dry or wet, guys. Keep it clean and keep it wet, because the more you keep it wet and clean, the better it's going to work and the longer it will last. So I always work my edges. You want to come all the way out to the edge. A lot of times you'll see people that will refinish cars or you know, they'll do a wet sand and a buff, and the middle of the surfaces look great, but the edges always look really bad because a lot of people are so afraid to hit the edge, because, you know, usually that's where your lighter paint is. So we'll just come back, spray, nice and clean. Now, from here, you think, oh, God, I've messed my light up. And now, the reason why this doesn't scare me, because generally what I do is I'll come in with 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, then I'll polish. I'll do a good cutting compound, polish it, and then put my coating on it. But this is a lot, seems to be a lot faster, And I would much rather do it this way than that way. So now I'm going to grab my IPC, which is basically, it's just alcohol. I'm going to hit it one time, and then this will help it get dry faster. There we go. All right. So now she looks rough. But now if you came back and like clear coated this, it would look absolutely amazing. But we try to stay away from the clear coats for the simple fact is when you have to redo the light again, it's a pain to get that old clear coat off. It takes a lot of sanding. Because clear coat's pretty strong stuff, guys. You don't want to... Yeah. So when this gets all chalky and stuff looking, I'll come back to you. All right, guys. We're back. I just wiped that through there. But as you can see, it's pretty chalky looking. So we're going to get this off. So they've pretty much made sure that you're only going to use this sandpaper one time. Which kind of sucks because, yeah. Again, it kind of sucks. So, look, it's already cracking. So anyways, now we're going to go on to our 3000 grit. 3000. Pop that on there. And you can actually order these little grits. You can actually order these offline. It's usually where I get them. All right, so we're going to go with a little bit of more water. Put that on there. Spray this sucker up. Remember, edges first. We went with the 3000 grit. I can still see some of the scratching in there, but that's supposed to be normal. And when we put the third stage on, it's supposed to pull all of that out. Now, usually from here, what I would do is I would come in with a heavy cutting compound and a heavy cutting pad and get this sucker really cut down, polish it, and then put a ceramic coat on it, and it'll look absolutely fantastic. But the problem is in my experience, they doesn't take a whole lot longer for those to turn yellow again. Because, again, usually a lot of people, when I do these for people, they don't really take that good of care of their cars. So they're not going to stay on top of worrying about keeping these things all, you know, looking pristine. I will, of course. So, anyways, let's open that third step up. And it comes with, it only comes with two pads. That sucks. Oh well, it is what it is. So, we'll tear that right on in half there. Lord, we're flying through the neighborhood. All right, so we're going to open this up. Pull this out. And it basically... looks like a wet nap. It doesn't smell too awful bad. It smells like basically the rest of their chemical. Oh, wow. Woo! Yeah, nope. That hit me good. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and get this coated here. There we go. Coat this sucker up. I'm going to go all the way around my edges. Yep, just like that. We're just going to cut it back and forth. Back and forth. And I think we're going to be good. Come on down. Whew. Stuff is strong, guys. Make sure you use this in a well-ventilated area. Okay. There we go. Put this back up because I got to do my other headlight. And I'm using this pad. Oh, geez. Should have worn my mask. All right, so there's that, guys. We will let that dry and see how it comes out. But, man, that looks fantastic. If that dries like that, that's going to look amazing. All right, guys. There they are. They're done. Do both your lights at the same time. That way you can just use one pad. Because my pads were plenty moist enough to do both lights at the same time. So, basically, I would do APC wash, APC wash. Wipe those off, come back, do my step one, come back, you know, of course, get all that wiped off, then do my wet sand 2000, get that cleaned up, come back, wet sand 3000, get that cleaned up, IPC, wipe all those off, make sure everything is good and dry around both lights, let that sit for about 10-15 minutes, wait till it's nice and chalky on both of them, come back, open your stage one or your stage three, and wipe nice and evenly. And guys, I am absolutely, I mean, I couldn't have polished that out any better, like legit. And what I like about this is I don't have to pull a polisher out. Now, I don't know what the durability will be on it. Only time will tell. But when this car gets painted and everything, I'm going to be rubbing this thing with a diaper. So it's like, longevity is not going to be a good test for me because my car will be so well taken care of. But I have some places I can use it. I could definitely probably do it on the Trailblazer, the detail truck, because those need to be done as well. And that'll be a good test for that because I don't really wash that one as often. Nowhere near as often, actually. So, anyways, guys, make sure you're wearing this because this stuff has a very high chemical smell. It smells like ammonia. I mean, it hits your nose like ammonia. So, I had to put a respirator on when I did it. So, just make sure you're either in a very well-ventilated area. Outside probably is going to be the best way to do it. And just make sure, you know, if you're indoors, your garage, make sure you have a respirator of some sort. I use this for coatings and stuff like that. So anyways, there it is, guys. I'm very impressed with the Cerakote headlight. I'm very impressed with our product so far. That Rapid ceramic coating is so good. It is really good. So I'm pretty impressed with their stuff so far. I can't wait to get the trim, do the trim coating, see how that works. Yeah, just impressed. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Comment, rate, and subscribe. Share the videos. That helps the video with YouTube algorithms and stuff. Let's grow this thing together. And as always, keep detailing. Never stop.